What are some do's and don'ts, real quick, for a buyer that is getting ready for mortgage pre-approval that they should do or not do?
I would tell you, make sure that your credit is in line. You know, it is free for us as consumers to always check our credit reports. So a lot of our clients may have an app. Maybe they bank with a certain institution or they have a credit card with somebody. I would advise them first, let's go on, check your credit score, see where you're at. Because if you need to work on your credit score, getting pre-approved with a lender right off the get is just going to ding your credit and make it that much harder to get that score up where you need it to be possibly. So definitely do your due diligence, check your credit score. Do some research, in my opinion, on, you know, minimum down payments. First time home buyers are allowed to do the 3% down, and then kind of figure out from there. Once you figure out what your down payment may be, do a little research on the houses that you're looking for. Maybe get with Laura and her team to figure out, okay, where's the price range that we want to be in this price range? These are meeting all of our wants and needs. So we're in this price range, then do the math on that to figure out, do I have enough to afford that for the down payment and some of those closing costs? So I would say, you know, check your credit, make sure you're in line with everything on your asset portion. And then ultimately your employment will be something that is what it is. But, you know, we look for a 2-year history. So have that ready and be ready to document that right away. W-2s, pay stubs, tax returns if needed, bank statements are going to be needed. So be prepared. That's the biggest thing that I kind of run into is preparedness is a huge thing that'll make a process like this that may be stressful and lengthy. It'll make it seem flawless and seamless and less stressful. Let's just say I can't take all the stress out of it. It is a big purchase. It is the largest purchase you're going to make. So be prepared. Know what you're getting into, ask questions, and don't be afraid to ask questions. That's a big thing. You know, a lot of clients don't ask questions and then at the end get caught off. I'd rather you ask more questions than not enough.
So I have one last question. Is it true that if clients are getting ready to go through the pre-approval process, they should stay away from large credit purchases such as a car, a boat, a vacation, or, you know, yeah, adding all the appliances when a credit card, is that true? They should try to stay away from that if possible?
Yeah. And I'll tell you, yes, definitely stay away from that before, you know, you want to go buy a house. If you want to buy a house and you're serious about buying a house, my best advice is let's wait until you get into the house and are a homeowner before we go out and buy a car or apply for a new credit card. But those are things too that I'm definitely going to at least mention or advise during the process. You know, no large purchases, continue to save your money, make minimum payments. If you're, you know, sometimes I'll tell clients that are making overpayments on their credit cards and things, let's slow that down. Let's continue to save, put away money, because I tell everybody the more money you have at closing, the more comfortable you are going to feel when the day we get done. Because you're always going to want to do stuff to your new home. Everybody thinks, no, I'm just going to move in. Move in ready does not mean move in ready, because we all know there's one room that you want to paint. There's a bathroom right that you'd love to do something to. Even though it might be beautiful right now, you're going to want to do things that are on you. Your personalizing of that house. So continue to save money. No big purchases. No credit checks during the time frame. But, you know, that goes along with, you know, just being prepared, doing your research on things that you should do, should not do. I think that will definitely go a long way. But yes, definitely no major stuff. Wait until we're done and we can furnish that whole house and get laundry, washers and dryers replaced once we're in. Yep.
Wait till we're closed, right?
Wait till we're closed. Once you sign, you get keys, then you can go to Lowe's or Home Depot and grab your appliances for sure.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much, Jared. We really appreciate your time and taking the time to speak with us. I know that I've done several deals with Jared and they've gone wonderfully and my clients thank have been you. Very pleased and they saved a lot of money. Thank so you. More information on Keller Mortgage, please contact us at the Roska Group and we'll point you in the right direction. Thanks so much, Jared.